Do you like studies? I know I do. There are lots of studies coming out almost weekly on laser therapy, and it's really amazing the range of conditions now that are being treated and benefited by laser therapy. The interesting thing is, none of these are above 500 milliwatts. That's a class 4 laser. What we're finding is that below this threshold of hazard, a class 4 laser, below that 500 milliwatts as determined by FDA, there's some fascinating research going on. Of course, a lot of it is being done by this company because a lot of veterinarians want to know, well, what do you have with your laser? What kind of studies have you produced with your laser? Because all these other sales reps and companies I talk to, they talk about studies, but it's by some other company. So we have undertaken a major effort here, and I'll just tick off some of these for you just to show you the range of conditions that are being treated now and tested now, empirically evaluated and optimized and validated. And one here in particular in the pre-exercise photobiomodulation therapy for cardiopulmonary exercise. And here's one for phototherapy on knee pain. It's double-blinded, randomized, placebo-controlled, and it actually appears in a peer-reviewed journal, which sort of is a gold standard, isn't it? So here's another one on improving performance with photobiomodulation and accelerating recovery for rugby players. Now, there's a group that really needs something like this. It's kind of like the hockey players. In fact, Multiradiance probably works with more hockey teams than any other company. But it's those types of athletes who are in hard physical confrontations that are typically getting injured a lot, but need to rehab very quickly. And we find this so much in the veterinary world, where we need fast recovery and we need more complete healing to prevent re-injury. So here's another one, the effect of phototherapy on a systematic review with meta-analysis. These are really our favorites because this lists a lot of different studies, but unfortunately only those that qualified and met the criteria. And this again is where class 4 tends to have some real difficulties because, well, oftentimes they don't meet the criteria set forth, and sometimes it's embarrassing for them because if the criteria aren't met, they can't be included. Of course, a lot of our studies are included, and that's what a good meta-analysis is like when you look at a company and try to evaluate where to spend your hard-earned money. And the bottom line for you, of course, is all this testing is wonderful, but where do you invest your money and get the best return? And there are many more studies. Photobiomodulation and skeletal muscle, from exercise performance to muscular dystrophies. And here's one on thermal impact. This one's pretty close to you here because this thermal impact can have a lot of implications and repercussions. But this is with concurrent superpulsed lasers and red and infrared LEDs on human skin. And what the research is very clear about is that there's really no thermal impact with a superpulsed laser. When your pulse durations are down in the nanoseconds, billions of seconds, you don't have these heat issues. And if you happen to be somebody with a darker pigmented skin, or if you happen to be an equine vet, a sports lameness vet, and working with white horses with a dark gray skin, well, sometimes a horse has its own particular way of letting you know it's getting hot and they're uncomfortable and they don't like it. Now, on the human side, they can just get up and walk away. With a horse, it's more impactful, isn't it? So here's another study. Different doses and wavelengths in skeletal muscle performance, fatigue and skeletal muscle damage induced by tetanic contractions in rats. So the point is that there are a lot of good studies out there if a company is willing to do two major things. One is to commit the money, but two is to be able to pass these tests, to be able to perform under these sorts of exacting circumstances, and especially to be accepted in a peer-reviewed journal. Now, we've had six studies as Multiradiance so far this year, six more coming the rest of this year, and Dr. Leal is now the second most published researcher in the world. Now, we think that's pretty remarkable because there isn't any other company that's matching this volume of quality gold standard studies so that you have something real to base your investment on. And this Pillars paper was another great example of that. And the Pillars is not just a marketing term, but it's talking about in vitro, in vivo, controlled laboratory studies, clinical studies, the kinds of standards that really mean something to us in the world where we're really wanting to be careful of how we spend our money. So this is on the mechanism of action. This is on discovering the optimal parameters. And this is on validation, the clinical trial pillar. There's a lot of important points in here, but chief among them is the fact that you don't want to overheat these tissues. You have something called the depth of penetration time profile. How much heat are you generating in the time that it's taking with your dose parameters, your dose time, and your total dose? And what are the ramifications of that? And when we talked about darker pigmented skin, We're really talking about how much heat is building up on the skin versus how much energy is getting through that collagen into the deeper tissues where it has a chance to do some good. Now, what happens if you're putting too much energy in is this energy is converted into heat. And that's something that we really don't need. Laser has never been photothermal. Laser is photochemical and photophysical. So you may be puzzled, but we're going to help you sort that out. We're doing a comparison here that was actually done by other companies, their own researchers doing the studies for them. But these were published, and so we had access to them. And you can see over here with a class 4 laser, there's a lot of heat building up because it's a continuous wave. The class 4 means it's hazardous. It has no implications, nothing to do with efficacy, but it has a lot to do with heat and possible vaporizing of water in the cornea or just burning. So that energy gets converted to heat in the collagen, and that means that not very much energy is getting into those deeper tissues where we need it, especially in the veterinary world where we might have a tendon, a muscle, a ligament issue, or a fracture that we're trying to repair. And we need photonic density in those tissues to give us that uptick in metabolic activity and the ATP that we need and increasing blood flow. Now, 3Bs did a little better, up to 20%, but still quite a lot of heat in the collagen. But when you're super pulsing in nanoseconds, 20 to 200 nanoseconds, billionths of a second, there's relatively little heat and relatively much more energy getting into those deeper tissues, 43%. And these are factual controlled measurements. This isn't something made up in a marketing department. So, puzzled, I can see why, but the research will help steer you to a great set of facts. In this latest Comparative Pillars paper, we take these issues head on. What we're looking for here is the right way to deliver the dose. We have the right time to deliver the dose, so that your time and energy profiles have been thoroughly optimized. And this talks about one of those byproducts of putting energy into tissues, the CK levels. The CK levels, the creatine kinase, are indicators of muscle damage. And this is a real important concern because it's not something you can see visually. You know, by the time you smell kitty fur singed in a vet practice, it's way too late. That energy getting into those deeper tissues is causing thermal damage and pushing way beyond that stimulatory mode and right into the inhibitory mode and then right into things that we can't see like tissue damage. So CK levels are a very important marker, and we have different times here on the recovery of muscle. And this is a really interesting way to quantify these processes that are going on. So this top line is a placebo. This next line is for different dose deliveries, like 10 joules, 30 joules, 50 joules. And what we're looking for is where are we getting the biggest retention of the beneficial effects? In this case, it's the 30 joules. And this was proven out over the course of this test based on the delivery of that dose over time to determine that the 30 joule dose is the most optimal dose to deliver. 50 joules was too much, 10 was not enough. This is kind of a little bit like Goldilocks. You don't want too much, you don't want too little. You want to stimulate, but you don't want to overstimulate. You want to keep it in stimulatory mode, you don't want to push it over into the inhibitory mode. The next really important thing we wanted to test for was pain relief. How long, how much to give us the inhibition to reduce that pain quickly, and how long might it last? And so of these three doses, 50 joules as compared to 30, as compared to 10, which of these doses over what period of time do we expect to see this pain relief last? And in this case, the inhibitory dose of 50 joules was the best performer. And it was not until 72 hours that the 10 joule was able to return to the baseline. The 50 joule gave us the best results. It was most effective immediately, most effective during the first 24 hours, most effective overall. So there are times where we want to deliver a larger dose. What we don't want to do is deliver too much dose and overheat the patient. And that doesn't happen with a super pulse laser. Let's address another great area for discussion, and that's this whole business of frequencies versus wavelengths, dose versus dosimetry, total dose, inhibition, stimulation. We can break that down for you now and set the table and make this much more simple. In the case of our Activate Pro, our core competency technology is a synergistic combination of wavelengths. In this case, it's the 660. That's your visible red. The 860, that's that broadband infrared, and then the 905, that's our superpulsed laser. Now, we can't see those last two wavelengths, but they're very important in the synergistic combination, which allows more passage of energy through that collagen into those deeper tissues. Now, we've added something else that's unique in the industry, and that's our 465 blue. This 465 nanometer wavelength blue is superb for causing oxidative stress to bacteria, and that means they can't mutate around that. That means they can't create a resistance to that like they do with so many drugs. So this combination of four different wavelengths plus a multitude of different frequencies is what gives us a very unrivaled status as a product for you. Now, what's all this about frequency? Well, frequency determines the rate with which the energy is delivered to the tissues. Sometimes we want it very low and slow, and you know, we optimize that for wounds. If you push wounds too much, you push them right into inhibition. You can slow down, you can retard the whole healing process. And that's why we don't encourage this use of class 4, because it's so much energy, you can push a wound right into, well, you can retard the recovery times for it. But if you're using low and slow frequencies like our 5 hertz as an example, or our 1 to 250 hertz as an example, you're maintaining these tissues in a stimulatory mode that below that threshold where the energy is being delivered at a rate with which it still is in a stimulatory process. There's an excellent way to illustrate this whole issue of dose and dosimetry and getting it right. And what we found through this study with Dr. Antonelli was that beneficial dosimetry could kick in at about 80 seconds. So we're applying energy into these tissues, and at the 80-second marker, we started to see these beneficial effects. And at 240 seconds, this optimal level was reached, where we were getting maximum benefits in these tissues. The biological processes started to be inhibited at around 400 seconds, so we could see that that was the proper parameter, that window of dose that would be the most appropriate to get the maximal beneficial effects. If you don't stop at that point, you lose this wonderful stimulatory effect and you cross over into inhibitory. With the inhibitory, you're starting to overload those tissues. You're starting to lose your beneficial effects, and you can even reach a state of cytophototoxicity. If you're applying too much energy, which is exactly what can happen with a class 4 laser, you're putting too much energy in and you're starting to open up a whole pathway to apoptosis or cellular death. So getting the dose right, keeping it small, keeping it stimulatory, is the key to giving you the best possible outcomes. Remember, optimized, validated, unrivaled, that's multi-radiance.